I'm Melissa Britton, I'm the CEO of Adjuster Pro, and you're watching Adjuster TV.
Going to court. I don't think that even if you win, it's gonna be cheap. In this video, we'll hear from some experts about what you can do to stay out of court and what to do if it can't be avoided, starting now.
You're watching the Property IA Show.
This video is sponsored by Kaplik. As insurance adjusters, we need to be covered by insurance. Get the free guide at cplic.net/adjustertv. And by the IA firm CCMS & Associates. To apply to this fast-growing and innovative firm, email your resume and a compelling cover letter to careers@ccmsclaims.com. Hey, it's Matt here with Adjuster TV, and for the best tips and tools for getting on the first call list as an IA, subscribe. It's one of the biggest things that you can do to help Adjuster TV. Don't act like you don't like it. Gives me chills just thinking about it. Getting called into court for one of your claims. Is there a way to avoid this? I think so. But if not, is there a way to CYA if you're sitting on the stand and your claim is getting picked apart? Yes. And if you do end up in court, who pays for all this? Maybe you. But there are ways to protect yourself with low-cost coverage. But let's dig into this a little bit, okay? So not ending up in court to begin with should be your ultimate goal. I think that's a maxim for life in general. Actually, we see an interesting parallel in the world of medical malpractice. Study after study shows that when doctors are nice and likable, their patients are more likely to do as they say and to trust them. An author, Malcolm Gladwell, helps to explain the reasons in his book, Blink. He says, the overwhelming number of people who suffer an injury due to the negligence of a doctor never file a malpractice suit at all. Patients don't file lawsuits because they've been harmed by shoddy medical care. Patients file lawsuits because they've been harmed by shoddy medical care and something else happens to them. In fact, Gladwell tells us, what comes up again and again in malpractice cases is that patients say they were rushed or ignored or treated poorly. Okay? So what's the first thing that you can do? Develop rapport with your insureds. Not every claim is going to be paid, right? And even on those claims you absolutely can't find coverage for, you've got to build a foundation of trust and rapport with the insured. Why? Mainly because if an insured feels like you gave them a fair shake on their claim, they're much less likely to give you a bad customer service rating, let alone drag you into court. The second thing you can do to build a defensible file, a file that even if the insured decides to litigate, you can confidently defend in front of a room full of jurors and attorneys. How can you do this? A couple of ways. First, always be asking questions of the insured. Is there interior damage? Any personal property damage? What questions do you have for me? Do you understand the process and what's going to happen next? And so on. The other way is to maximize your file accuracy by eliminating distractions during your scope and when you write your estimate, okay? We do not multitask in claims. We can't. Anybody who says that you must either has never run claims or wasn't very good at it, okay? If your phone rings and you answer it while you're measuring your room, what's going to happen? You're going to either write down the wrong measurement or you're gonna forget to write down the measurement, okay? If you engage in task switching while you're doing critical work, you'll not have as accurate a file as you would if you left your phone in the truck and concentrated on scoping each loss in a repeatable, consistent order, same way every time, no distractions, okay? I've never been called into court on any claim I've ever handled, and I've handled a lot of claims, okay? I like to think that a combination of great bedside manner and rapport, along with more accurate estimates, contributes to this. Coming up, Kenton from CPLIC and Sarah from CCMS explain what happens when you get sued as an adjuster and what you can do on your initial inspections to help avoid a claim going to litigation. As adjusters, we need to be covered by insurance, right? We're writing estimates, climbing ladders, walking on roofs, making coverage decisions, right? And mistakes can happen and they will happen. So what are you gonna do when something goes wrong? Kaplik it. CPLIC, or Kaplik for short, is an insurance company for independent adjusters formed by independent adjusters. They understand our job and the potential problems that can arise. So if you want help understanding what coverages you need, head over to cplic.net/adjustertv for a free download that will explain the common types of insurance for adjusters.
I'm Kenton Kaplan with Claim Professionals Liability Insurance Company. We refer to ourselves as Kaplik. We offer professional liability policies predominantly to independent adjusting firms, independent adjusters, umpires, appraisers, E&O insurance, errors and omissions, which is a necessity in the life of a field adjuster. So it's easy for us, like I've been in this world for a long time. So if you're just a new adjuster starting out, maybe you haven't gone through those experiences. Again, like I was saying earlier, you haven't had a claim made against you.
Right.
And it's scary when people start accusing you of doing something wrong and you know you didn't do anything wrong, but it doesn't stop them. And the next thing you get a letter from an attorney. And if you're out there on your own, you may not know what to do with that letter. And you know, that's where we come in, right? And you turn that over to us and we help, you know, we help you respond or we respond for you. We really like to try to find a way to help people out. So most common it'll be either you do work outside. So like we don't cover attorneys or agents or public adjusters, for instance. So that might disqualify you, or it's an experience factor. We like to see 5 years of experience, but we do accept sort of transferable skills. So maybe you're coming from the construction industry or residential home inspections or appraisals or something where you're kind of in a similar industry, even if you're not doing claim inspections.
My name is Sarah Rusignello. I am the Director of Litigation and Liability for CCMS and Associates. One of the biggest things that we see during an initial inspection is somebody who is rushed. And, you know, we understand that your schedule is very busy, but sometimes it creates more work for you and for the carrier on the other end if you rush through an inspection. You want to make sure that you cover absolutely everything. You want to make sure that you really address all of the concerns that the homeowner has. Take the time to talk to them. What is it that they're really concerned about? And get as many photographs as possible to really document the condition of the home during the inspection. A lot of times we see that somebody makes a claim for a roof and they say there's just a small stain in the kitchen. And if the adjuster goes in and they only take a picture of the small stain in the kitchen, 6 months later, the homeowner may say, well, but there was also some additional damage in this other room. There's no photos of that other room. We really don't know. And a lot of times it's because the field adjuster just kind of rushed through the inspection. It's very important to build the rapport with the homeowner. You want to make sure that they feel comfortable with you coming into their home. I think sometimes people feel like it is an invasion of privacy that somebody is coming into their home. They're taking photographs. But during your initial calls, you want to make sure that you are building the rapport and make them feel comfortable with you going into their home and let them understand that you're there to help them and you want to be able to resolve this claim for them as much as they want to resolve it. A lot of times, this is the most catastrophic situation that somebody has been through. So you want to make sure that you're walking them through and letting them know what to expect, when to expect it, and give them the opportunity to really tell their story.
Next, Kenton and Sarah talk more about how to protect yourself when you're running claims, and even some work opportunities if you want to help out on claims to keep them from going to court, which is pretty cool. But first, are you looking for an IA firm where you're not just another number? Then let me tell you about our sponsor, CCMS and Associates. CCMS has been called a big mom and pops firm because they care about their adjusters. They also care about results. The CCMS family is dedicated to training and developing a talented adjusting team. If you would like to become a part of the family, email your resume and cover letter directly to careers@ccmsclaims.com.
E&O, as a concept, it protects you when an allegation is made that there's inadequate or somehow negligent service or in your professional services. So if you're out at a residence or a commercial building and there's a dispute in the claim, everyone's well aware of the bad faith environment, and carriers will get sued all the time for coverage or underpayment or delays or whatnot. But what independent adjusters may not realize, they get drug into that a lot. Even if they did nothing wrong, if there's any sort of allegation that their professional service was performed inadequately or negligently, that's what the E&O policy covers. So it's not only a good risk management practice for adjusters to have E&O, it's really a necessity. So typically, it's gonna be generally a dispute in scope or price. Just as you see between the carrier and say a homeowner, even though it has nothing to do with the independent adjuster, they might go out and write an estimate, and the dispute is really between those other two parties, the adjuster gets roped in. Now, unfortunately, there's also situations where sometimes a mistake is made, even accidentally. It's really costly because it's not so much as just correcting that mistake. Generally, not generally, but oftentimes a lawsuit will develop. And even the cost of defending yourself against a frivolous lawsuit might be $10,000, $20,000, $30,000. And that's where the E&O policy covers you. That's where Kaplik steps in, and we offer that not only the indemnity, should there be some, but it's really that cost of defense, which is the most valuable benefit. You know, essentially, as soon as a claim is made, or a homeowner, or again, an insured of some sort, comes forward and says, I dispute this insurance claim or the resolution of it, large times the carrier will step in and handle it. But again, the adjuster is always involved. It's not just when a lawsuit is filed. Proactively, we can get involved as well. And then we can work with the carrier to help get that claim resolved or get the claim tendered to the carrier so that they can defend you and it won't trigger your policy. But we're still there to help you through that process. Right, it's not just the monetary benefit. We are there to assist you. A lot of people, it's funny because the independent adjusters are obviously in the claim world, but it's different when you have a claim against you. And a lot of people, fortunately, haven't experienced that. And it's a little unnerving when someone's coming and saying you did something wrong. So that's where we step in and we are, you know, hand in hand through that whole process. And if it comes to retaining defense counsel or going to trial or through court and whatnot, that's obviously something we handle all of that as well.
My role is to oversee the pre-litigation and litigation adjusters. They're mostly desk adjusters. However, we also have a side of that does field inspections. It's mostly dispute resolution. Our ultimate goal is to try to avoid the case going into litigation. It saves the carrier a lot of money and certainly makes the homeowners, the policyholders, a lot happier if they can get their case resolved without having to go through the court system. Well, in most of these cases, the property has already been inspected once, and this is usually a cat situation. And a lot of times that we find during a cat situation, you can't always see all of the damage. The initial adjuster is going out and the property may not have full demo. There may be a tree on the house, but you can't actually see all of the damage. So we send our dispute resolution adjusters in after the home is ready for an absolute full inspection. There's typically a contractor, sometimes a public adjuster or an attorney, who has gone out and inspected the property, and they found some things that maybe were not visible during the initial inspection. So the dispute resolution field adjuster will go out, they'll take a look at everything that is being claimed as additional damage or new damage, and they try to reconcile the difference and ultimately reach a resolution that the carrier is okay with and that the homeowner is okay with as well. Definitely a little bit of negotiating, and it's certainly a skill that is developed over time, and we work with the adjusters. We provide training to make sure that they feel comfortable going into those negotiations. A lot of it is about concessions, and we may not necessarily agree 100% with the need for everything on their estimate. However, there are things that maybe the insured's representative can agree that they can shave a few things off of their estimate, and we can maybe add a few things that we normally wouldn't. However, in order to just fully resolve the claim, it's something that everybody can live with.
If you found this video useful, you'll love writing along with us on Adjuster TV Plus. Myself, Chris Stanley from IA Path, Guy Grand from Veteran Adjusting School, and others show you how to handle claims with confidence. We know it's hard to find a working adjuster who has the time to let you shadow them, which is why we let you write along with us on Adjuster TV Plus. Check it out for 7 days absolutely free at adjustertvplus.com. Adjuster TV is the premier video resource for the independent adjusting community, and we're committed to bringing you the best, most up-to-date, and entertaining programming to help you learn what adjusting is all about, if it's right for you, and how to build a rewarding career as a claims professional, a career where you can help people in their time of crisis and earn a great living. For much more information about becoming a successful property or auto claims IA, including many more videos, free tutorials and webinars, the best gear and software for claims, and industry news and IA weather reports, head on over to adjustertv.com. And as always, thank you so much for watching and have a great storm.